The U.S. will not allow China to isolate Taiwan. That remark from House Speaker Nancy Pelosi after her visit to Taipei Wednesday triggered unprecedented military drills by Beijing. Pelosi insists her trip was not intended to change the status quo in the region. But she stresses American politicians should be able to travel to Taiwan freely. Pelosi spoke in Tokyo, the last stop of her Asia tour.
The Chinese made their strikes, probably using our visit as an excuse. They may try to keep Taiwan from visiting or participating in other places, but they will not isolate Taiwan by preventing us to travel there. We've had high-level visits, senators in the spring, a bipartisan way, continuing visits, and we will not allow them to isolate Taiwan. They are not doing our travel schedule. The Chinese government is not doing that. Our friendship with Taiwan is a strong one. It is bipartisan in the House and the Senate. Overwhelming support for peace and the status quo in Taiwan.
China on Thursday launched its largest military drills around Taiwan, with missiles flying over the self-ruled island. China claims Taiwan and has threatened to annex it by force if necessary. The U.S. Secretary of State warns China against starting a crisis. Antony Blinken spoke in Cambodia, where he's attending the ASEAN-U.S. ministerial meeting.
The United States continues to have an abiding interest in peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait. We oppose any unilateral efforts to change the status quo, especially by force. And I want to emphasize, nothing has changed about our position. And I hope very much that Beijing will not manufacture a crisis or seek a pretext to increase its aggressive military activity. We in countries around the world believe that escalation serves no one and could have unintended consequences that serve no one's interests, including ASEAN members and including China.
Blinken will be in the Philippines Saturday and will meet with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The two are expected to discuss Washington and Manila's alliance in the face of rising tensions in the region. Catch Karen Davila's interview with Blinken on Head Start Monday, 8 in the morning, only here on ANC. The Biden administration postpones a long-planned test of an intercontinental ballistic missile to avoid escalating tensions with China. It's the second delay for the Minuteman III test. The first postponement was in March in a bid to quell tensions with Russia over its invasion of Ukraine.
We do not believe it is in our interest, Taiwan's interest, the region's interest, to allow tensions to escalate further, which is why a long-planned Minuteman III ICBM test scheduled for this week has been rescheduled for the near future. As China engages in destabilizing military exercises around Taiwan, the United States is demonstrating instead the behavior of a responsible nuclear power by reducing the risks of miscalculation and misperception.
Taiwan's premier denounces China as a, quote, evil neighbor next door. Su Tseng-chang says they didn't expect Beijing to arbitrarily jeopardize the world's busiest waterways with its military drills. Taiwan President Tsai Ing-wen also condemns the military exercises as irresponsible. She notes Taipei will neither escalate conflict nor instigate disputes, but it will resolutely defend its sovereignty and security.